Thank you, everybody. You've been really wonderful to play for. I got one more song for you. It's really, really long. It's the epic ballad, so dig in. This is my favorite of all my songs. I never get to play it because it's really long. This is the place where I wasted my life. This is the room where I waited for you. Now that I knew what I was waiting for, here is a pad where I wrote down your name. Yeah. And here is a stain where the mattress used to lie, lie, lie. And all this remembering, this painful reverie, shall make a man hungry for burger and fries. So I will cross the mighty parking lot, concrete divider in the retail shops, by the old shopping plaza where nobody goes, by the Boulderama, the hit or miss, the floor champagne less and the moral kiosk, concrete windows in ancient Greece, cinder blocks, space police, walking through the drive-thru, the manager says hi. It was an Arthur Treacher's. Before that, they tried this baby as a Lucky Walls. 80 square feet working kitchen with functional features. Doomed to be the home of third-rate fast food restaurants. I like the whole system here. I like the yellow and white. I like the stupid crown they give you when you purchase your Sprite. Well, if I could, you know that I would stay here all night. Just kicking back in my plastic booth and make me feel all right. Well, before they closed the Lucky Wongs, this wasn't Nathan's Famous. Yeah, for about 6 months they tried this baby as a jack-in-the-box. They tried giveaways, promotions, and generally acting shameless. And blameless as us nameless patrons of fast food restaurants. Not too many in here now except for me and the flies. And this little Brad is crying cause he got mustard in his eyes. His dad is scraping it off the back of the bun with a butter knife. It's all so deeply horrible, it's great to be alive. Well, before they closed the Jack in the Box, this was a Ponderosa. Well, before that it gets sketchy, but I remember this vaguely frightening lums. The bathrooms are impeccable, but the tables could not be grosser. They serve delicious irony in fast food restaurants. I got a job now. Yeah. Yeah, I've been working in the transport train. I don't know what it is or what the hell I do, but I do get paid. Why don't you meet me at the Burger Express? I could buy you a whammer, a slammer, or a happy meal. Please say yes. Yes, yes. But I suppose you wouldn't like that. You prefer something natural. Just one more instantiation of how you couldn't care less about the mighty parking lot and the concrete divider and the retail shop by the old shopping plaza that used to be hopping when I was a kid and my mama took me shopping. I remember sitting at the corner at Schnackenberg's counting my pennies for a shot at the brass ring. This box does not contain instant winner. Please try again. Well, before I was Napoleon, I think I was Cleopatra. In a past life, don't you think I was Genghis Khan? But now I'm me and I'm duty free like a truck dispatcher. Doomed to spend my life in third rate fast food. Nobody looks at anybody, we're all nothing to see. There's no one within miles who could stir feelings of jealousy. This really is the perfect place for a loser like me. Just kicking back in my plastic booth and letting beings be. But before this was a strip mall, this was a colonial wheat field. And before that, this land was Lenape burial ground. Oh, but me, I take my stand by the salad bar with the plastic spit shield, filling little ketchup cups and hanging around. Oh, but I'm not going down. No, I'm not going down.
Thank you all so much for listening. Thank you. I'm Tris McCall. Karen Davis is fantastic. Thanks to Karen for playing. And thank you so much, Grace Church, for having me. Thanks for giving me the, thank you for giving me the courtesy of another. All right.